Since I was little, I have always been a fan of cars. And now that I want to improve at making games, I challenged myself by learning how to make a car in 3 days. And of course, without using any pre-built chassis. So now, let's begin! First thing first, I needed to do some research to know how to make a car. At the beginning, all the tutorials I found was either someone telling me to insert a chassis, or the car from the thumbnail looked like this. Yeah, I think I'll pass on that. But after a bit of research, I found this tutorial from this Roblox documentation. So thank you to Slatenik because this tutorial was so good. But before starting it, I needed a car model. So I directly hopped into Blender, I inserted a reference image, and I watched this video from RoBuilder to know how to make an image 3D. So here I am tracing the outline of the image so after I can make it 3D. After, I extruded the edges and I already had the basic form for the car. And with this, I was able to start to work on the back. Not gonna lie, at this point I was starting to struggle a little bit because the back of the car wasn't symmetrical, and that's when I realized that this wasn't going to be easy to make. In fact, I never made a good car model before, and the only ones that I made are this. Yeah, that's trash. So I assembled all my skills, all my stamina, and all my strength to fix this issue and finally finish this car. Okay, so the car is actually starting to look like something right now. So I'm going to add the wheels and we'll see how it looks like. So there it is, y'all. And honestly, this is by far the best model that I made. It's just so, like, I'm really happy about it, even if it's not the best, but. So now it's 8 PM for me, so I'm gonna take a break, and I think that I'm going to script the car tomorrow. But yeah, I learned a lot by doing this thing, and honestly, I'm pretty happy right now. And day 2, I started recording at 4 PM because I was busy. But basically what I did is just add a few changes to the car, and after I exported it to Roblox Studio. And there it is. Wait, hold up. Much better. Since the car model was done, I could finally start rigging the car. So the first thing I learned is that all the cars you see in Roblox games don't really look like this. They actually look like this. And I'm going to show you why. So there's two main reasons for this. One is to have a better center of mass. Here, I needed to make all the parts massless beside the red part. And the second reason is to don't have bumpy wheels. So I needed to add those green cylinders because their hitbox is way better. After this, I'm not gonna try to explain you everything because it was a bunch of tedious stuff like add welds, attachments, and suspensions, so yeah. Okay, so let's see if this works right now. And yay, let's go. That's cool. Yo, it's moving. It's my own car. Like, what's up? Look at this. It's working. Okay, so the guy from the tutorial said to change the free lunge of the springs, I need to make the free lunge too, just like this. Oh yeah, it's way better now. What about this? So now, yeah. Oh wait, hold up. So if I put the free lunge to 2, it's supposed to be straight. Okay, yeah. Oh, okay, there it is. Why is it like this? Like, I can push it like a cart. But yeah, it's working now. Like, there's... Yo, what is happening? Yo, nah, now he's dancing. Blade, what is this? This is so fun. After this, I tried to fix the problem, and all I needed to do was move the center of mass higher. Yo, look, it's working now. But what if I jump on it now? Oh, now it's all right. Okay, so the guy from the tutorial said to add 2 ramps like this and then make the car go on them. Oh, let's go. It's so cool. And after this, I was ready for day 3. So, on day 3, I directly went on Roblox Studio and made the server-side script. What I needed to do was pretty simple. I inserted a vehicle seat in the car, and when a player touches the car, he will get in the vehicle seat. Okay, so now it's supposed to work. I'm supposed to be able to go in the car and... okay, it's glitching out right now. I think I need to make the seat lower because we can see my face out of the car. Okay, so I'm going to make it just a bit lower. So now it's supposed to be better, I guess. And yeah, we can still see my hair. I think what I'm going to make is like, when I get out of the car, I will TP my player there instead of directly here. He didn't set it in the tutorial to do that, but I'm going to add it. I'm going to make it just like that. And I think this is going to be better. So now if I get in the car and then I get out, yeah, just like this. I think I'm going to add just one more number. Yeah, this is way better. Okay, so I also made so that when you enter in the car, you become invisible, and when you get out, this is not supposed to be there. Oh, there it is. I wrote humanoid root part, so it's supposed to be humanoid, and now, normally, it's supposed to work. So, yeah, there it is. After, I finished the tutorial and added my own things to the car. Okay, so as you can see on the screen, I added a speedometer, and I made so when you enter in the car, there's now the headlights open and the rear light when you brake, and I also changed a little bit the values to make the car more controllable. So I made this for the steering wheel because when you're too fast, it's kinda difficult to turn. I made so it reduces the max steer angle. So here's the rear light script, and here is how I made the speedometer. So I get the velocity position, and then I get the magnitude, and I divide to make it kilometers. Okay, yeah, whatever. Let me show you the final result. And for the last test, I built a looping and we'll see if the car can go through it. Okay, so while we're gathering speed, I just wanted to thank you for watching the video until the end. And all the research that I made will be linked down in the description. And also, if you could just leave a little like, you know, it would help me really well. Let's get it. Bro, okay, yeah, no, wait, hold up.
Bruh.
Okay, 3, 2, 1, this is it, yay, let's go, we get it, let's go man, let's go, huh, what?